Hi, this is Colleen with Keeping Peace 2010, and you're back for another episode of Colleen Answers Your Questions. Today we are in the down bar of episode 12 in this same series, and we have a question from A. Mac Ectoman. You've already seen one of his previous questions, so I'll give you a link here to his previous question. He asks really good questions. Today he says, I put the thumb of my support hand, which happens to be his left, over the right hand. I am not a good shooter. Are these two things related? I will give your alternative a try since I don't have anything to lose. In your experience, how long does it usually take for a poor shooter to become a mediocre one? I have no reason to believe that I'll ever shoot well enough to compete, but I need to be capable of defending myself up close. However, I do enjoy the challenge of target shooting at the gun range. I just get frustrated by my lack of accuracy. Thank you. Okay, that's actually two questions, but we'll go ahead and address them in one. I believe what he means, I'm going to use my carry piece here. I just emptied it. There we go. Okay. I believe what he's talking about is when he places his hands on the gun, he actually does this. So he puts the thumb. I can't point that direction because there's a road over there. So he's got his hand maybe down this way and he puts his thumb over top. What that does is it makes an air pocket. This entire side of the grip portion of your gun is not touching your skin. So naturally the gun's gonna wanna move in the path of least resistance when recoil is happening. So if you find your shots a lot walking to the left, since you're a right-handed shooter, that may be the cause of that. If you can get hand contact on the side of the gun, it's going to really help you. There's another episode in this same series where I answered a question from Shaw Tackle about having to readjust his grip. If you go look back at that episode, I show you in detail how you can seal your grip together, seal the two hands. That would help prevent things from slipping, and that also would help for your situation. If you'd like to, it would really help me to tell you what's going on if you could send me a picture of your target. The email here on YouTube is keepingthepeace@gmail.com. If you'd like to send me a picture of your target, if you can send me a picture of several targets, that'll give me a really good idea of what might be going on. Because I can just imagine if your shots are falling leftward, that would make sense if you have no contact with the left side of the gun. However, there might be other things going on. Just a note, a lot of times if you have random shots all over your target and no group, what you're doing is looking at the target rather than at your front sight. So that might help you. If you're grouping, but your group is not in the right place, that's a totally different issue. If you have no group, then you're looking at your target, and you got to force yourself not to do that. Look at the front sight. Let the target be slightly blurry in the background, okay? You also said, how long does it take to become a mediocre shooter? It depends. If you're spending a lot of time practicing the wrong thing, it can make you feel like you're getting worse and worse. It would probably really help you to get someone to watch you shoot, or maybe just sending me your target can let me help you give some things to work on, because if you keep reinforcing the wrong thing, then you're just going to keep driving yourself in the wrong direction. You kind of need to get someone to help you address what your issues are, maybe one at a time, conquer the things in your body that want to do the wrong thing, because those are reflexes, totally natural. And then as you conquer each problem, you can keep getting better. Generally, I tell people practice an hour a week at the range if you can, if you're really working to conquer something, but spend five times that in dry fire at home. Because that's where you're going to make the biggest bulk of improvement in your shooting is dry fire. So I hope that helps you. I know that's kind of a brief answer to your question, to questions, but I hope it's helpful. Please send me a picture of your targets. I'd be happy to help you more, and I think that'll help a lot. If you can send me a video of you shooting, that'd be even better, but I can tell a lot by your target. So hope it's helpful, and maybe it'll help other people too. God bless. Bye.